Alright, so for game two, we look at this opener. An opener like this, where you're pretty prone to missing your third land drop, is kind of awkward. This one I'm willing to keep, though. Since we at least have Augur, and Dissipate's pretty good in this matchup, I think. And then we have Jace for the win condition. Augur hopefully finds his Think Twice, which it does. Azorius Charm is like also the card that helps us get out of land screw, but okay, so we didn't miss here, which is very good. Now we're a lot less worried. Leave Dissipate mana open, even though I'm sure we're probably not going to cast it on anything. Yeah, that's fine. 3/3 is just fine. We get to think twice. If we ever get to cast a Jace with blockers in play, then we're doing really good. And yeah, here we definitely just pass. Think twice, Dissipate open. We're not going to block either. We want to leave the Augurs in play for Resto or for blocking for Jace. And I also represented Restoration Angel here, which he walked right into, which is interesting. It could mean he has a few things. Could mean he has Selesnya Charm, Azorius Charm, his own Restoration Angel, or if he, it could just mean he doesn't care. So really, we don't get a read off that. He shows us Think Twice, so now we actually assume he doesn't have Resto. Selesnya Charm is the most likely thing, but once again, he could just still not care and just be attacking into Resto with nothing. All right, this is a little awkward. So we're gonna miss our land drop here, and we have to choose between discarding or not having a Dissipate mana open while casting Augur. I think, once again, I don't really know what we would need to dissipate, because any creatures we just wrath away. So we could get away with playing Augur. We should probably still have to discard, but at least then we could have a think twice, maybe. Just missed on our Augur. Don't have to discard at least. And now I don't attack, just because I'm not going to beat him through damage, or I don't expect to. But I'm definitely not going to block here. I'm not going to block with both, at least. I actually could see myself blocking, like in case he just played a creature and I wanted a Wrath. But since he Far Seeked pre-combat, there's no chance of our Mono Worm, so I probably should just take it and then have both Augurs around still. Also, that protects from Wolf Run, so that if I just land Jace, he can't Wolf Run and kill the Jace if I just double block. So instead, he actually just spheres, so don't have a chance to block. That's fine with me. I'm okay with him spearing two Augurs. All right, so don't have land once again. Really, really awkward, but I'm just gonna cast Revelation for one here. I'm still in fine shape. Okay, hitting that was very crucial. Now I'm in fine shape, and I actually get to play Jace if I want to. So 3, 6, 8 mana. So he has nothing relevant currently. He could have Resto. I think he also forgot about his Think Twice, I'm pretty sure. He could have Resto, Counterspell. Either way, Jace is a pretty bad card to play here. So I think I would rather just. Actually, I have options. I could Charm and try to find a land, which is the only way, or not, that's not the only way I wouldn't have to discard. I could also Devour Flesh. Devour Flesh definitely is a safer play. Then I could Charm end step. And, or if he plays Resto, I could Charm the Resto, then play Jace. Actually, I probably would Dissipate a Resto. Yeah, he plays Resto, which I do Dissipate. He doesn't flashback Think Twice, so he's on complete error. Plays a Wolf Run that he would have had to draw, would have had to have drawn, that is. Okay, so Angel Serenity, not on complete error, it turns out. Just had something not worth casting yet. So with finally a Wolf Run in play, I don't have to just play around it in case he has it. I have to actually play around it. And actually, the truth is he probably should have held it. So how do we play around that effectively? We can't play Jace. I think the best thing I could do is Revelation for two and pass. I actually didn't end up doing that. Interesting. Rather, not just pass, but hopefully hit a land. What am I thinking here? If I Azorius Charm... Or no. I can't Revelation. I can't tap out. If I go to 14 here, Wolf Runs for 6. Go to 3. Okay, so I was actually thinking pretty reasonably here. Just gonna Azorius Charm. Hope he goes all in and play Azorius Charm. That's still really weak. So he didn't go all in, so instead I get to Revelation. Yeah, actually I was thinking much clearer when I was doing this. And if he adds anything to the board, I get to Wrath. But now I just get to Revelation and have Charm open for next turn. Finally remembers his Think Twice. Alright, this is really sweet. Now we're going to Charm, have Dissipate open, and have another Charm. Discarding Jace is not a big concern at this point in the game. He goes for Lethal. I Charm. Plays Healer. And I'm sure he's going to play the Healer. And now I still have options. If I Dissipate this, I get to resolve Jace and mill his Angel. If I just hope to draw a land, then I can... Actually, you know what? That is definitely worse. Hoping to draw a land is definitely worse. I mean, I have to waste my Dissipate to do this, but that's perfectly fine. I think he has just nothing. And I finally have a Jace play and I'm stable. So definitely going to Dissipate. And then Jace plus one. If I hit a land drop, I'm completely safe. But if I'm not, that's just fine also. Or if I don't hit a land drop, I'm just fine still. I'm sure he doesn't have anything with haste. Ends up drawing another Angel of Serenity or having it. I'm sure he could have had that. In addition to Detention Sphere. So we're still doing just fine, actually, believe it or not. Jace kind of is a card that enables that to happen. Yeah, so we draw land, we're gonna Jace plus Charm. If we didn't draw land here, it would have made things really awkward. If I Jace and plus one to try and hit land, I might just die. But if I did anything else, I'm just throwing away cards in hopes that I draw land on the next turn. Or rather, like, I'm buying an extra turn so that I can take another chance with Jace to hit a land. But luckily I hit that land, so he's just pretty much dead. He can't work through all these removal spells. Before I deck him out. Yeah, so we Wrath, we have Azorius Charm in hand just in case of a Resto down the road. But he's actually dead. I mean, he's gonna have one card. Revelation, this means he's dead. He has no outs. Or I guess he was drawing to a Detention Sphere. Which would still leave him pretty much dead to the Drown Yard. Alright, so after game two, I learned a little bit more about the deck I'm playing against. So I boarded in 2 Cleansing and 1 Duress for Charm and 2 Restos. So the Restos normally aren't that bad because they block other Restos, Centaur Healer, Beast Tokens, sometimes Thragtusk. But when they have Wolf Run, it gets a little worse. So I decided to cut the Restos for that reason. And, the Duress actually, I'm not sure if that's the correct thing to bring in. I think Negate would actually be better. The only way Duress is better is if they have Slaughter Games. In this case, I can Duress pre-Jace, which is sometimes a little better than Negate, but I'm not sure that's really valid. Even if he has Sphere and that does happen, then I still have Cleansing. So maybe the Negate would have been better, but that's about it.